what should you charge as a virtual assistant or virtual expert? In this video, you'll discover how to set your rates. You'll learn 4 traditional pricing models and 1 non-traditional pricing model that I created. Hi, I'm Kathy Goughenour, business coach and trainer exclusively for virtual assistants. I've helped hundreds of women just like you achieve their dreams of working from home as well-paid VAs. On this YouTube channel, I'll show you how to create a VA career and gain the freedom, flexibility, and financial security you desire and deserve. A huge myth that I want you to dispel from the very beginning is that you should set your rates based on how much you need or want to earn. I'm gonna say it straight and blunt. That's baloney. Clients do not care how much you need or want to earn. They care how valuable your services are to them. If you demonstrate that your services are worth $100 an hour, they'll pay it. If you demonstrate that your services are worth $10 an hour, they'll pay it. And everything in between, and even higher. So, how do you set your rates as a virtual assistant or virtual expert? Start with 1, research. Find out what other VAs and VEs are charging for the service you offer. Identify the highest rate, the lowest rate, and the average rates. Then 2, assess yourself. Determine your level of knowledge and experience. If you're brand new to providing the service you offer, you're going to be at the low end of the rate spectrum. Then as your knowledge and experience grows, you'll want to increase your rates to the average level. And as you become a true expert in your specialization, you'll want to price yourself as the highest in your field. You also want to consider your pricing model or structure. You can choose from 4 models that are popular today. The first one is an hourly rate. You keep track of the amount of time you spend working. And at the end of each month, you multiply the time you've spent for that client by your hourly rate and invoice your client accordingly. The second model, project rate. You charge based on the value of the entire one-time project. Ideally, I recommend getting 25 to 50% of the total project price up front and then setting milestones throughout the project for additional payments along the way. For example, you could do a 40% up front, 30% at midpoint, and the remaining 30% when the project is complete. The number of milestones and payment vary depending on the length and price of the total project. I personally love this way of pricing, both as a VA and as a client of VAs, because as a VA, you get paid based on the value of the project rather than an hourly rate. Project rates are more difficult to set up as a newer VA because you often are unsure of what to charge or how long a project will take. So again, do your research, get experience, work with a coach like me who specializes in helping VAs grow their business, and you'll quickly know how to price projects. Pricing model 3, retainer rate. Clients pay upfront each month for X amount of hours in that month. That X is usually a quantity of 10. 10, 20, 30, 40. If the client does not use all the hours that they prepaid for, by the end of that month, they lose those hours. As you can imagine, I am not a fan of this pricing model because in my opinion, it hurts the client. And anytime you hurt the client, they're not going to stay with you long term. Pricing model 4, block of time. You sell a block of time, such as 10 hours, for X amount of money. This model is a cross between hourly rate and retainer rate, because you charge your hourly rate and get paid up front. Now, I promised to tell you about the pricing model that I created. It is different. I call it a not-to-be-exceeded monthly budget. High-paying, long-term clients love this pricing model because they can set a budget. They don't have to worry about how many hours you're working in any one month, because together, the two of you have set a monthly cap. It benefits you as a virtual assistant because you have the freedom to work and work and work up to that cap. And then when you're close to the cap, you simply email and let the client know how much more work you have to do for them that month. And then they determine if they want you to wait until the following month to do the work, or if they want to give you written permission via email or Slack or text to exceed their budget that month and by what amount. To learn more about how to get high-paying, long-term clients who love working with you, please watch my free webinar by clicking the link below. Please subscribe to this YouTube channel so that you get all the videos that I'm creating, and I'm doing a minimum of 2 a week. Also, click like on this video and comment. Let me know what you think of it.